And that's what the devil does. He's fine with you being small-minded. He's fine with you having low self-esteem. He's fine with you having no focus or no determination or no purpose. But as soon as you find your purpose, that's when the devil tries to kick you and mess with you, because he doesn't care if you don't know what your purpose is. You see, that's why devils mess with prayer warriors and preachers and those people that really affect people's lives, because he understands that if you can affect change in somebody's life, if what I say or what I do can cause you to want to know how to get closer to Christ, then it's going to give the devil an opportunity and a reason to affect me. And so the children of Israel were becoming great. They were becoming a mighty nation. They were becoming a powerful nation. And so Pharaoh of the time was very afraid. He was very afraid that the children of Israel would rise up. And he even said in the scripture, he said, let's go deal with them. He told his head men to let's go deal with the children of Israel, because when we deal with them, what we would do is this: we will keep them from teaming up with our enemies. And if we allow them and we keep them from teaming up with our enemies, we can be okay. So Pharaoh gave a decree or an edict. In that decree or edict, he said, what I want you to do is, the way we're going to go and destroy the children of Israel is, I want you to take every Hebrew boy and I want you to throw them into the river. Watch this. He said, I want you to throw them. Can you turn the heat down a little bit more? Is anybody else hot? Whew. He said, I want you to throw them into the river. And so now Moses was born. Just let me tell this story real quick. Moses was born. And when Moses was born, he was a Hebrew child. So his mother had to do what the Pharaoh said do. I want to show you something. We know that every Hebrew child was thrown into the river. They were thrown into the river to drown. They were just cast into the river. Why? Because he was trying to diminish the population of Hebrew children. When you begin to think about that, you look and you see the power that Pharaoh had. He said, throw them into the river. So when Moses was born, his mother did just that. That's where Miriam comes in. Miriam was Moses' sister. And so Moses' mother told Miriam, put the baby in a basket and throw him into the river. Now we know that she set him in the reeds and up amongst the grass and floated him in the river. Watch this, I want to show you something. When the devil tries to put you in a pitiful place, the Lord will set you up and put you in a better place from whence you left. When the devil tries to put you in a pitiful place, the Lord will cause you to go back to a better place from where you left. So we know that Miriam did what was told of her. Miriam, she put Moses in an ark of reeds, and she pitched it with the pitch. And so she put him in the water, and he floated down the river. And Miriam looked there and sat there and watched as her baby brother, a brother that she loved, who was about 3 to 4 months old when this happened, a brother that she loved, she had to watch him go down the river. So when she let the baby Moses down the river, the Bible tells me that the baby floated into a bathing area. And there was Pharaoh's daughter, the Egyptian, better. She was there and she saw Moses, who had been thrown into the river just as the Pharaoh had decreed. He said, you've got to throw him in the river. And so Moses gets in the river and he floats down to this bathing area where the Egyptian women were, and Pharaoh's daughter saw the baby and picked him up. Here's Miriam, watch this. Miriam released the bundle of joy, her baby brother. She let it go. And when she let it go, Pharaoh's daughter picked the baby back up. And Miriam stood afar off and watched all of this happen. And when Pharaoh's daughter took Moses up, Miriam looked at this, and Moses' daughter said, "We need to have somebody nurse this baby." So Miriam ran over to her, and she suggested, because she was a Hebrew woman, so she just simply suggested, "Well, maybe we ought to get a woman from the Hebrew tribe to nurse this baby." Pharaoh's daughter said, "That's very interesting." She said, "Okay, what we'll do is you go find me somebody. Watch this. You go find me somebody and you bring them here to me and you let them nurse this baby." I said all that to say this: when you learn how to release what God has given you and have enough faith that when you release what God has given you, He's going to give it back to you 10 and 20 fold. He's going to be able to give you more than what you have. All right. More than what you have. More than what you could ever fathom. The reason why some of us are not blessed is because we're afraid to release some things that God wants us to give up. He wants us to let go of some things. We're holding on to it. We think it's ours, but it's not ours. It's God's gift to us. And when we learn how to give what God has given to us back to Him, that's why when we bless children, it is symbolic of us giving our children back to God. Mm-hmm. Your talents are not a gift that you have. Your talents are a gift from God to you, but how you use those talents are a gift from you to God. If you can sing and you're not singing the things that God wants you to sing, then you're not giving the gift back to God that God has given you. So Miriam gave up her baby brother. And she was smart enough to know that the baby brother that she had was going to be all right. So when she saw Pharaoh's daughter grab the baby, she went over and said, "Perhaps we can have a Hebrew woman nursed this baby." So Pharaoh's daughter told Miriam, "Go find somebody." And Miriam found who? Moses' own mother. And it put Moses right back into the place where he left. And so that's the first encounter we have with Miriam when she was born, and or when he was born, and put him into the reeds and floated him down the water. Then she saw Moses come back. And for about 10 to 12 years, Moses was raised as a Hebrew. But he had to leave again. He was raised and he had to leave again. And so here is this baby that I gave up 10 years ago, 12 years ago. I watched my little brother float down the river, and God provided for him and put him in a place where he would bring him back to us. And so now he had to go again because he was weaned, he was raised. And so now he had to go and live as an Egyptian. So when he left again, here is Miriam again. "I seen you leave one time, and now I'm seeing you leave again." Isn't it funny how when God gives us something and then He takes it away, He may not give us that same thing back, but He'll give us something better. And if He doesn't give us anything better, He gives us the memory of that which we have. Until we learn how to let go of what God has already given us, we cannot increase. We can't increase. Until we learn how to let go of what God has given us, we cannot increase. I want to do this illustration. That's your point. Hold on to that point. Whatever you do,
what do you trust? You trust? I need somebody to play for that. Thank you, man.
I want you to whisper in her ear to deceive her and tell her not to get that hurt. Okay, there's the devil in your ear. Hold on to that corner tight. Okay? Give me the corner back. But wait a minute, she's standing there and she's not giving me this corner, is she? Why? Because the devil, Evangelist Moody, is all in her ear telling her not to give up what she's got. With the quarter. Right?
Oh, yeah.
He's blessed us with that. Are you going to give me that quarterback? Well, look here. If you would have enough faith not to listen to the devil, I want to give you this 5. But I can't give you this 5 because you're listening to the devil and you're holding on to the little blessing that you already have. I cannot give this to you when you don't have enough faith to release what is already in your hand. Because you're listening to the devil to tell you, you already got the 25 cents. So if you don't want to release it, but when you learn how to release, you see how to open your hand and give back what God has given you, right? And when you give back what God has given you, it's more tithing. When you give back to what God has given you, God will increase that thing, and you can only receive, you can't receive anything like this. Right? But when you learn how to give back to God and you open your hand and release what God has already given you, then little becomes much when you place it back into God's hand, and God can then bless you.
Amen.
With more money, more sustenance,